women. More information on our programs at Body Chemistry Associates, 34 years in the business of human nutritional biochemistry, 1-800-CHEMIST, 1-800-243-6478, 7 days a week here from 2 to 3 p.m. on WWNN. More information on our programs at Body Chemistry Associates, 1-800-CHEMIST, 1-800-243-6478, on the web, 1-800-CHEMIST.com. Jay Foster and Health Connection Radio saying thanks for tuning in today. Enjoy the rest of the beautiful day. We'll be with you again tomorrow, too.
The preceding sponsored program were strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Talk 1470, WWNN, Pompano Beach, Boca Raton, Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
If you suffer from excruciating back pain, do not have surgery. Call Dr. Fernando Ranella, MD, and ask him about the new ozone therapy and how it can eliminate your back pain once and for all. End your suffering today. Call Dr. Fernando Ranella, the Center for Back Pain Management, 561-819-6325. That's 561-819-6325, or injectpainaway.com.
Hi, this is Michael Blum. Join me on Mondays from 9 to 11 p.m. on WNN for the Michael Blum Show, where we talk about the things you don't want to talk about. We talk about sex, substance abuse, spirituality, and politics. Think, speak, and be heard. Join us on the Michael Blum Show.
If you've decided to get back to feeling good again like you used to feel, then you're invited to tune in to the Dr. Bob Martin Show. Hi, I'm Dr. Bob, at your service Sunday mornings at 10 on Talk 1470 WNN.
Hi, it's Jay Foster. Join us 7 days a week from 2 to 3 p.m. for Health Connection Radio. We'll talk about natural cholesterol control, toxic metal syndrome, how to reverse bone loss, and the latest scientific research on vitamins and minerals. We'll have fascinating guests, and we'll take lots of your calls, too. So join us 7 days a week from 2 to 3 p.m. for Health Connection Radio right here on WNN.
AM 1470 with even more information you can use. Are you suffering with chronic pain? Tune in for No Bones About It with Dr. Alvin Stein. You'll learn non-invasive techniques that can help you get rid of your pain without the use of harmful drugs or surgery. That's No Bones About It with Dr. Alvin Stein. Tuesday mornings at 11, right here on AM 1470 WNN, South Florida's Health and Wealth Network.
What you want to know. What you need to know. Talk 1470 WNN.
The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
The information on this program is not intended to be a substitute for or a replacement for any professional medical advice or services. You should not use this information to diagnose or treat a health issue or concern without consulting your qualified healthcare provider. Coaching for Health always advises you to seek advice prior to starting any new treatment or regimen of any kind. Any actions and applications resulting from the recommendations on this program are at the listener's discretion. Welcome to Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker. Suzy is a certified health coach and has her practice based in Delray Beach, Florida. Listen here to find out how Coaching for Health can help you get and stay on the right path to your health and wellness. Spend an hour learning about current topics on all things health and how you can apply them in your life every day. Now, here's Coaching for Health with our host, Suzy Bricker.
Hi, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to this Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker. That would be me, your certified resident health coach. I'm going to be probably putting my glasses on and off a little more today. I don't know. I think my eyes are getting worse, but that's, we're going to talk about that in a sort of kind of way today with my wonderful guest who I'm going to introduce in a couple minutes. But let's get back to today. It is February 10th, 2016, Coaching for Health every Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m. on WWNN Radio. You can get us on WWNNradio.com. You can stream us live. You can get us on iHeartRadio. You can get us on iRadio Now. You can get us on TuneIn. You can get us on Amp2.tv. You can get us on YouTube, Coaching for Health. You can go on my website, www.coachingforhealth.net. And if there's anything I forgot, shame on me. So again, it's February 10th. It is pre-Valentine's Day week. Sunday is Valentine's Day. It is the day for lovers and likers. And I don't mean the Facebook likes. I mean likers and lovers. Tell the person in your life you like them, you love them, your family, your children, whoever it is, your pets, your best friend, your worst friend. It's Valentine's Day Sunday, so celebrate. All right. Again, it's my honor and my pleasure to be with you every Wednesday from 1 to 2 p.m. on this health, wellness, and finance wonderful station. It's all about integrative health and wellness, nutrition, supplements, exercise physiology, mind-body health, even pet health, and more. It is about living independently healthy. So I'd like to start every show with just a brief explanation about what health coaching is and what I do as a health coach. And it's all about bio-individual programs, mentoring, hands-on, getting to know my clients in a way that they, and getting my clients to know themselves in a way that they have never known themselves before. It is a, again, a mentoring, hands-on, health and wellness booming profession in this country. It's the way of the present and the future. We are extremely knowledgeable in nutrition. I'm versed, well-versed in over 100 nutritional theories, supplements, exercise physiology, mind-body integration, as I said, and much, much more. So if you are interested in a health coach or you would like to talk to a health coach, I will give you information about how to reach me every break. And if you're in another area, you can always contact me and I can refer you to someone if you would like to achieve your optimum health and wellness. So that's all about that. I'm only going to do one hot health topic today because I want to get into our show, which is extremely important and timely. And all of our shows and my shows, I hope, are important and timely. But this show is really critical. It's about aging. It's about caregiving. And we all are caregivers. We all have parents, siblings. So we all at some point in time are going to be a caregiver to someone or people that we love. So we're going to get into that in about a minute. But I wanted to just touch on one hot health topic for this week. And that is about souping versus juicing. Now, I've talked about this in shows, previous shows, and this is a big nutritional topic and program I put together for my clients, but I'm just going to mention this briefly, that I am not a proponent of juicing for a lot of reasons. It is not healthy, it is not healthful, and it really does get your blood sugar level out of whack. I am a proponent of souping, and souping is the way of the present and the way of the future in nutrition. It is healthful. It is healthy. When you eat soup, you get nutrients. You are able to chew. You are able to metabolize your nutrition. It is predominantly liquid, but it is a very, very healthy way to cleanse, so to speak. And I'm also not a proponent of cleansing. But it is a very healthy way to add something different into your nutritional program. So anybody that's interested in souping, you can get a hold of me. We can talk about it. Anybody who's doing it, keep doing it. And it is a great and I think a better alternative to juicing. So there. Okay, Donna, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Let me, first of all, welcome Donna Addy. She is my esteemed guest for today's show. I am honored to have you. It is a pleasure to have you. Thank you. Let me just give you a little bit of information about Donna Addy. She is an independent marketing consultant and is currently the director of business development for the Artists Senior Living, a memory care residence with communities in either development or operating from Massachusetts to Pennsylvania, extending down the eastern seaboard into Florida, our wonderful Florida, throughout the Midwest with expansion plans headed towards the West Coast. And she's going to talk about this facility as well as a lot of other things in about a minute or so. For 17 years, Donna has had the privilege of meeting and speaking with unpaid caregiver with unpaid caregivers, families, advocates, care partners, and key professionals. She was born and raised in New York, graduated with a sociology degree from SUNY Oswego, got married outside of Philadelphia, and made the Maryland Chesapeake Bay area her home, where she raised her family for nearly 20 years. Pre-internet, she owned and operated a traveling consulting business until being introduced to the senior living industry, where she began marketing and consulting with assisted living and memory care residences. And now I'm going to introduce her, Donna.
Hello.
And please, again, welcome to the show. It's a pleasure and an honor to have you. This is a very, very, very important show, and one that I am just so thrilled to be doing today. So I didn't read your complete bio. Please tell our audience, fill in the blanks, tell them everything and anything that we would like us to know about you.
Well, I was fortunate enough to get into the senior living industry. I was working with the Chamber of Commerce in the Annapolis, Maryland area, and I would run into a woman, and every time I talked to her, she said how much she loved her job. And it was at the tail end of, right, I always say I got in out of travel the day before the internet was invented. So every time I saw her, she said she loved her job. And one day I said, well, I'm going to explore her job. And her job was in senior living. And the rest was history. It'll be 18 years in June. And I am very passionate about helping families find solutions. They often feel like they're alone, whether it's general assisted living or whether it's memory care. Mm-hmm. And I want to be a resource for them. And so I have come to be, I'm probably one of the greatest connectors of helping people, say, when they're at their end and they're like, I don't know where to turn. If they contact me, I guarantee I will find them at least the next person who is going to help them on their path. So my grandmother had Alzheimer's. I was not aware of it when I, prior to getting into this industry. So I would say, my grandmother would say, Donna, I can't find your mother's telephone number. Well, you know, I thought she was a busy woman. And she would call me later on in the day. I can't find her number.
I go through that every day. I can't. Well, part of that is because my cell phone just erases the numbers. Oh. I have to blame it on my cell phone. But yes, you're right. Go ahead.
You know, I thought it was perfectly normal. Until I got into the industry and really learned that that was the beginning signs of her cognitive decline. But I've learned a lot. I've worked very closely with the Johns Hopkins University.
What a fabulous institution
that is. In fact, my company, Artist Senior Living, who I work for, they sat down with Johns Hopkins over 20 years ago, and they created the program that they are offering now for those who have cognitive impairment. So I place a high value on my own education. I am constantly reading as much as I can. It's very difficult to absorb everything.
Oh, of course. And we're going to go over some statistics here in a couple of minutes. I believe some staggering statistics about boomers. I'm a boomer, and caregiver stress and all things that are going on with this very important topic. But please go ahead.
I often give presentations, and if you're a boomer, you'll remember the show, of course, Ed Sullivan.
Of course.
Naturally. And Ed Sullivan was actually a precursor to America's Got Talent. And I often think we must have been very simple, because what amused us back then would not hold any water to now.
Isn't that the truth?
Now the person has to be hanging by their teeth from a fighter jet, practically. But back then, they had a gentleman. His name was Eric Bren, and he used to keep plates rotating.
It was I remember that.
And he would have a rectangle table with rods coming spaced in between, and he would go and twirl the rods and get them going. And first he'd start with the one, and he'd work down to about 5-6 rods. And he was running back and forth all the time.
I remember.
And then he would put the plate up, and then he'd go to the second one. Now the first one started wobbling, and the chaos and the anxiety of that show, you know, we were all, you know, sitting there on the edge of a seat. What's going to
That's
happen
right. That's
if
right.
everything comes crashing down? And, of course, he wouldn't have an act if everything came crashing down. So he did a very good job. But if you watch it on YouTube, the funny thing that strikes me now is while he is doing all that chaotic activity and entertaining us, a very calm music is in the background. And
That's interesting you mentioned that. Now that I think about that, I never noticed that. I was too busy watching the spiraling and the anxiety of, oh, my God, and go back to this one and that one. And, okay,
and so
it's interesting.
What makes me tell that story is I want you to be the calm music in the background. If
that's
you are
fabulous.
Caregiving,
that's
I want you
fabulous.
To be that music. So while everything's going on, you are surrounding it with your calmness. And that's what I want.
That's really fabulous. Well, you can see how fabulous Donna is and how much knowledge she has and what an incredibly interesting and pertinent and important program this is going to be. So let's take our first break. Stay with us. We're going to talk about some caregiver statistics and a lot more. So don't go anywhere.
Could one conversation change your life? When was the last time you talked and worked with someone, the right health practitioner, about your health and wellness? When was the last time, or maybe the first time, you received the personal attention and the individual program you deserve? Because no one program works for everyone. And the only program that will work is the one that is truly yours. Coaching for Health is a hands-on, customized health and wellness program that truly will change your life. Suzy Bricker, a certified health coach, will be your personal advocate for living an energized and healthy life. She works with her clients to help them create and maintain a way of life that is healthy, flexible, fun, free of denial, and last but not least, gets results. By working together, bio-individual programs and lifestyle changes are made that are sustainable and that best support and target the individual needs and goals of each client. For more detailed information, please go to Coaching for Health website at www.coachingforhealth.net or email coachingforhealth at susan.brickert@outlook.com. Get the results you are looking for now and for the future, and give yourself the gift of great health and wellness that you richly deserve. Call Suzy at 248-762-4961. Stress is dangerous. We live in a world where we are subjected to it each and every day. These stressors can wreak havoc on our health, cause disease, and affect our daily lives. Stress seems to create or worsen conditions like obesity, weight issues, high blood pressure, Alzheimer's, diabetes, depression, gastrointestinal problems, sleep disorders. Well, the list goes on. It creates a whopping 80% of all visits to the doctor in this country. Enter adaptogens. Natural longevity adaptogens. Adaptogens are a unique, amazingly powerful group of ingredients that adapt their function according to your body's needs. They are the most effective, side-effect-free natural stress reduction solution on the planet. Better sleep, better stamina in all areas. Improved circulation and increased overall feelings of well-being are just some of the stunning benefits. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. That's ADAPT, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. Natural longevity adaptogens, the most powerful formula, period. Whether your business has 5 employees or 500, they need to work as a winning team. Your bottom line depends on it. Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health will work with you and your staff individually and collectively to build a customized plan that will work for your business. Suzy specializes in health and wellness programs that will improve employee productivity, reduce absenteeism, create a happier, healthier work-life environment, and increase staff loyalty and commitment to their careers and your company. All of which adds up to a greater return on your investment for you. Lower healthcare costs, attracting highly qualified new employees, and promoting an atmosphere of financial success. Contact Suzy Bricker at Coaching for Health at 248-762-4961 That's 248-762-4961. And at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. For more information, go to her website, coachingforhealth.net. Find out today how to build and create the right health and wellness program for your business. Call 248-762-4961 or email susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. Do you want to be epic? Do you want to be ultra epic? Well, now you can be. With Natural Longevity's Epic Ultra, you can take your health and wellness to a whole new level. Vitamins and minerals are critical to our overall health and well-being, but not just any vitamins and minerals. They are not, and I repeat, not created equal. There are no other products available that contain the same level of all vitamins and trace minerals and other phyto, meaning plants or plant-based nutrients, that Epic Ultra provides. This is absolutely the multivitamin mineral product everyone needs and can take with ease. This potent formula contains over 100 vitamins, minerals, and phytonutrients essential to great health, fortified for your heart, immune system, digestive system, mood, anti-aging, and more. Epic Ultra is a non-negotiable addition to your everyday health routine. So, go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio to see and order this amazing product and to view all the incredible products in the Natural Longevity family. That's adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. And remember the number 4, that's adapt, forhealth.com/WWNN radio to order now.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to this Coaching for Health with Suzy Bricker, your certified resident health coach. Again, it is February 10th. I am on, and I have a fabulous guest today, Donna Addy. This show is on every Wednesday from 1 to 2 on WWNN Radio. All right, so before the break, Donna Addy and I were talking about caregiver stress, and that's what this program is all about, caregiver stress and caregiving and statistics and all kinds of things we're going to get into in the remaining parts of this show. But Donna, just in case, for those of our audience that are just tuning in, briefly again, tell them who you are and what you're doing, and then I want to go over some statistics about what's going on with aging and certainly caregivers, and then we're going to get into some definitions and that kind of thing. So please.
I am a marketing consultant for a community called Artists Senior Living, which we have properties from Massachusetts down the Eastern Seaboard. We're getting ready to open a new one in Boca Raton, and we go up to the Midwest states and with expansion plans out to the west coast of California. We provide care for those with memory loss. So that would be Alzheimer's, other dementias, Lewy bodies, prefrontal lobe dementia, those who have cognitive impairment and they're able to reside with us and get good care in a very rewarding kind of environment where we really celebrate what they can do. And that's really what I do.
Which is pretty amazing. Now, when is the facility scheduled to open?
We are looking for the Boca Raton community to be open in mid to late spring of 2016.
So that's pretty timely.
Yes.
And that's terrific. And again, thank you for being here. It's a pleasure. It's an honor. This is an incredibly important, important topic, certainly in this part of the country, but everyone has parents. Everybody has somebody at a point in their lives, I would think, that they're going to have to be a caregiver for and to, and vice versa. So let's get into some statistics, which I think are pretty staggering. And I'm going to have to read these because my memory can't. I'm an information junkie, but I can only remember so much. My sponge is getting, the holes are a little less holy these days. So I did a little bit of research, and let me just mention a couple of, I think, staggering statistics, and then Donna's got more great information. When we talk about baby boomers, we talk about people that were born between the years of 1946 and 64, which is 20% at least of the population. Now, I'm a boomer. Donna's a boomer, and I would say that this is, or we call them the sandwich generation. Yeah. This is a good section of caregivers today is our generation, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Those who are maybe caring for a parent, and then they also still have children at home, perhaps in high school or college, and they're balancing all three.
So it's multi-generational, and we're really sandwiched between our younger generation and all of the things that go into parenting younger people in this day and age, and then older generation, and there's a real chasm. I mean, there's a big gap between the two, right?
Well, and also, thanks to medical science, our family members are living longer.
Right, we're going to talk about
that. So that's why there is such a prevalence of the sandwich generation. But we're the meat, you know. We're the beef.
We're the beef. Now we know where the beef is.
Right.
All right. So, a couple of interesting statistics. Between 2012 and 2050, the United States will experience considerable growth in its older population. In 2050, particularly, the population age 65 or over is projected to be 83.7 million people. 83. Now I know that's 2050 and it's we're not there yet, but this is where we're headed, and I think that's pretty staggering. A couple of other things. The baby boomers are largely responsible, which would be us, for this increase in the older population. So Donna, you know, we're in for a ride.
Yes.
So that's pretty staggering. And we begin turning 65 around 2011 or so. I mean, I'm not there yet, but that's kind of where we are. And one other fact that I think is pretty interesting is the older population will become more racially and ethnically diverse, and the projected growth of the older population in the United States will present challenges to policymakers and programs, which is another show. But let's talk a little bit more about statistics.
I looked up some statistics, and I found that an estimated of 43.5 million adults in the United States have provided unpaid care to an adult or child in the last 12 months. So there are a lot of statistics out there. It is, no one's going to remember all of them. All you just have to remember is, wow, that's a lot.
Now, what is unpaid? Talk about the unpaid care.
Right. And unpaid care would be if you're caring for your spouse, if you are a wife or a husband caring for your spouse or your partner, or if you're a parent caring for a child, or now many times you're caring for a relative and even a friend. I think many of us remember the show Golden Girls.
Oh, yes.
And and many of my friends say, well, we're all going to buy a house, and we're all going to live together, and we'll hire a caregiver or an aide. That's the paid part, where you hire someone from an agency to come in and you pay them. In theory, that's nice, but that's television.
Right, exactly.
And,
well,
except
Betty White is doing incredibly, so we need to know what she's doing.
And I think one of the characters did have Alzheimer's, which,
yes.
So that would be one in four, I think. So,
okay.
Yes, people are doing caregiving, and I find the biggest challenge is that individuals don't identify themselves as caregivers.
All right, which brings us to a very important point. Give us the definition of caregiver, because we were talking about this before the show started, and you mentioned something that was extremely important. Most of us, and I lost my parents many, many years ago, and I became a young caregiver, but most of us don't realize that we are. So what is the definition?
When I looked up the definition, There was not one definition, and I was challenged because they had all different definitions, but I liked this one, and it said, there is no one definition of caregivers or caregiving. and we define caregivers as relatives or friends who provide a wide range of unpaid care to dependent children, spouses, parents, siblings, I think you mentioned siblings,
yes,
other relatives, friends, or neighbors. And caregiving is the actual action to it. But there is no, it's not in a neat box.
It's in a very messy box, isn't it? It crosses party lines. It crosses generational lines. Mm-hmm. And it's on a minute-to-minute basis because everything changes.
Right. And sometimes you think, well, I'm not a caregiver. I'm just a daughter doing what I am obligated to do. And that's something I find this to be interesting, that caregivers often express that they had no choice and that they're doing it out of an obligation. But that starts off nice, but eventually they begin to feel overwhelmed.
Yes.
Caregivers often live in fear. They don't know whether they're doing the right thing and what's going to happen next, and will they know what to do? And then it gets even worse. They feel imprisoned often.
And that can lead to anger,
absolutely,
resentment, communication problems. It can lead to relationships falling apart, the relationships of the marriage, the spouses, or the boyfriends, girlfriends, parent-child relationship. It can really lead to the breakdown of a lot of life relationships.
Absolutely. We often say one mother can raise five children, but I guarantee five children cannot help
raise
one mother.
Right.
Because if you want to see a breakdown in relationships, watch three, four siblings decide what is best for their parent. And as I always say, I don't think you could get four people to decide what restaurant they want to go to.
That is so true. That is so, so true. All right, before we go to our next break, let's briefly talk about the definition of stress. Now, I did a show a couple of weeks ago on stress, but what is the definition, Donna, of this kind of stress?
Well, again, I also looked up the definition of stress, and there was all different kinds of definitions, but I liked this. It's fairly basic, but a state of mental or emotional strain or tension resulting from adverse or very demanding circumstances.
Now, that's a pretty concise definition. I agree with that wholeheartedly. In the stressors of every day, there's a lot of perceived stress, but this is real, hands-on, day-to-day, minute-to-minute stress. And that is predictable in the sense that you know that there's going to be, I think it's on a minute-to-minute basis, and when you take care of one situation, it creates another, and there's a snowball and a snowball and a snowball, which it can pile stress. It's like a Napoleon of stress.
Exactly. That's a very
pastry
good picture.
Right. Okay. We're going to go to our next break. When we come back, we're going to talk about some research. We're going to talk about recognition and validation, managing our stress, and a lot of other great points with Donna Addy, so please don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Stress is dangerous. We live in a world where we are subjected to it each and every day. These stressors can wreak havoc on our health, cause disease, and affect our daily lives. Stress seems to create or worsen conditions like obesity, weight issues, high blood pressure, Alzheimer's, diabetes, depression, gastrointestinal problems, sleep disorders, well, the list goes on. It creates a whopping 80% of all visits to the doctor in this country. Enter adaptogens. Natural longevity adaptogens. Adaptogens are a unique, amazingly powerful group of ingredients that adapt their function according to your body's needs. They are the most effective, side-effect-free natural stress reduction solution on the planet. Better sleep, better stamina in all areas, improved circulation, and increased overall feelings of well-being are just some of the stunning benefits. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. That's ADAPT, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adapt the number 4 health.com /WWNN radio. Natural longevity adaptogens, the most powerful formula, period. Being the best takes time, talent, and determination. Getting the most of those things takes coaching. Think of the most successful athletes or performers. They've all got a stable of experts coaching them in every area of their lives. Don't we all wish we could get, let alone afford, that level of service? Well, you can, without sacrificing quality, by working with Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health. Suzy has extensive knowledge of healthcare strategies, including nutrition, supplements, and exercise physiology, combined with life and career coaching. The results are life-altering, immediate, and sustainable. To find out how you and your family can benefit from Coaching for Health, go to the website coachingforhealth.net or send Suzy an email at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. Don't forget to schedule your free consultation and be on your way to the healthy, happy life you deserve. Call 248-762-4961. You've heard the saying, you are what you eat. Think about it. And for most of us, that's not a pretty picture. Compound that with the way our bodies metabolize and break down what we put into them, or not. Well, that's truly a recipe for disaster. Because we primarily consume a diet of processed foods, foods that have no or relatively no enzyme or nutritional content, we create disease all over the body. Heartburn, fatigue, inflammation, of course digestive issues, and a compromised immune system are just some of the issues we deal with daily as a result of this. Enter digestive enzymes. Natural longevity digestive enzymes. PhytoBioForte digestive enzymes and trace minerals. PhytoBioForte is the most potent plant-based digestive enzyme with trace minerals product available. Completely digested foods are the answer or solution to many health problems. And if you begin a daily routine of using PhytoBioForte, you may be amazed at what can happen. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. That's adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. Natural longevity, PhytoBioForte. The choice is yours. Do you catch colds too often? Do you suffer from too many sore throats each year? Perhaps your immune system needs a boost. Elijah Insurance Formula from Natural Longevity is a unique supplement that combines therapeutic levels of plant phytochemicals that support your body's immune system and health. This is a unique nutraceutical supplement that is based on groundbreaking research that suggests that extracts of certain plant chemicals have healing effects in the body. These can be greater than the physical benefits from eating the whole plant or the average daily amount of fruits and vegetables consumed in our not-so-great American diet. Elijah Insurance Formula combines therapeutic, antiviral, and antibacterial. Levels derived by plants, powerful antioxidants, digestive enzymes, green tea, vitamins A, C, and E, the mineral selenium, and more to create an extremely potent supplement for health each and every day. There is no other product in the marketplace today that provides some of these ingredients, and no other product comes close to containing all these ingredients at the same therapeutic levels as Elijah Insurance Formula. So give yourself a new insurance policy with Natural Longevity's Elijah Insurance Formula. Go to adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. That's adapt, the number 4, health.com/WWNN radio. For complete product and ordering information and to view all the incredible products in the Natural Longevity family.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker, your certified resident health coach. We are having an amazing discussion with Donna Addy, who is currently the Director of Business Development for the Artist Senior Living and Memory Care Residence with communities in either developing or operating from Massachusetts to Pennsylvania, where there is a facility opening here soon in the spring in Boca Raton. And this show is all about caregiving and stress and all kinds of other things. So before the break, we touched on stress. Let's just wrap that up a bit, and then we're going to get into recognition and validation, which is really, really important. Right, Donna?
I believe so.
So we were talking about stress, and you mentioned something about stress in the break, about good stress and maybe some tips about managing stress in this case.
First off, I think we have to recognize that we are stressed. So many of us, you know, we do so many things and we're juggling so many things in life. But someone says, oh, you seem really stressed. No, I'm not.
It's true.
You know, when you snap at the cashier because or the person in front of you has 11 things and you're like, this is a 10-item aisle. And you're driving and you're pushing the cars in front of you. That's stress. And every single one of us have experience. And if we stop and just say, whoa, slow down a little, Donna. you're being a little overstressed. And one time I remember when my kids were in high school and I had snapped at the receptionist at the school desk. She didn't know what to make of it. I ended up getting her a very big bouquet of flowers and acknowledging that I am stressed, but my stress didn't have to be her stress.
Exactly, exactly.
And sometimes I find when we're stressed, sometimes all we need is just a hug.
Oh, let me just mention, now that you mentioned that briefly, I'm going to... I had something prepared today about hugging. That's all I'm going to say. Mm. I will present it to my audience next week. But all right, that's good. That's a great segue. So you got to tune in next week for hugging because it's really, really important. Okay, please go on.
And sometimes we need something more if we are caregivers. We need what is called respite, which is a short break. And there are resources out there where you can have a respite care, somebody come in. Again, maybe paid, maybe volunteer.
Mm-hmm. Very important because we think that we have to be on call 24/7. Right. And if we don't control, everything's going to fall apart or we're going to be responsible or something is going to happen.
Right.
And nobody's going to know what to do better than we are, correct?
Exactly, exactly. Okay. But sometimes your friends are just, they feel helpless and you're holding everything inside. And if you would just say, can you come sit with my mother for 2 hours,
right,
and talk about, it's actually very enjoyable to do that. When I go into our communities, if I am feeling stressed, I go in the back and I will talk to our residents and I'll sit on a bench and I'll start conversing with them and I'll say, well, do you think the bus is going to come? And they'll say, I don't know. And I'll say, well, I hope Joe isn't on vacation. Because when Joe is on vacation, you never will know when the bus is going to come. And this conversation, although seems nonsensical, they are feeling a sense of belonging.
Correct.
They have a purpose. Yep. And my blood pressure is now completely relaxed.
That's very
so
true.
Sometimes you just need respite. Sometimes you need to just be vocal and say to somebody, I need help. I'm waving a white flag here. Can you give me any help? So that's so important to me, that you are honest with what's going on with you. Follow your gut. Your gut is going to tell you before your brain that something is not right.
Right.
And when you start seeing yourself having to stop at Wendy's for Frosties every day, that could be a sign.
Well, that's a nutritional no-no, but that we'll get into that in another
exactly,
show.
Exactly, but that's where stress shows up,
that's
as we
right.
well know.
That's right.
So I had found there is a fellow by the name, and he's pretty popular. I think he was on Oprah, and his name is Sean Acker. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. Mm-hmm. And he is now probably one of the world's leading experts on happiness and success. Mm-hmm. And he wrote an article in the Harvard Business Review about making stress work for you. Because as Suzy and I were talking, people give stress, I think, a bad rap. And I think often, sometimes when you're under stress, and it can be good stress,
That's right.
Things are going to happen.
That's right. I talked about how to live healthy with stress in last week's show or the week before. And again, my memory can be a little sketchy. But yes, stress is not a bad word. It's not, doesn't have a bad connotation. And that's very important, certainly in the caregiver realm and in our daily living. So I know one of the things that you really wanted to talk about was recognition and validation. So let's get into that a bit.
Well, I'd like to say there are no gold medals for being a martyr. So unfortunately, we think we're doing everything right. When I was a widow, an unexpected widow, for the first year, I managed to keep everything I felt exactly the same. So I spent more money as though I was printing it. And we went on wonderful vacations. And at Christmas time, my kids said, "Mom, you've got to take some of this back. You've given too much." And at the year anniversary, and I was under extreme stress,
extreme stress.
And at the year anniversary, I realized the next day that no one was going to give me a medal. And
correct.
That I should have, I was upset, I was disappointed in friends that they didn't come through for me, but I was giving the persona that I had everything under control.
As we do in our daily lives.
And it was a mask that I was wearing, and I know caregivers are the same way.
Yes.
When they go to work, they know they can't go into work talking about how they didn't get any sleep the night before. So much is expected of an employee.
Oh, of course.
And
absolutely.
I really want people to just acknowledge that they are human and they honestly are doing the very best they can under these circumstances.
But why is it? Why is it? And I have been through this recently, as a matter of fact. Why is it that that doesn't really happen? Guilt. Again, you talked about obligation.
Mm-hmm.
We think that we're super people.
Right.
So how, if we can get into this, we're just a little bit of a kind of transgression. How do we understand that that's not capable? And that's not also good for the people that we're taking care of, correct?
Well, I think we're afraid of feeling vulnerable and showing the world that I don't necessarily have it all together.
And what's wrong with that?
But there's nothing wrong with that. But we, in this financial economy,
yes,
people were very, very afraid to lose their jobs. Things are lightening up a little bit. Mm-hmm. But when I moved down here in 2007, rolling into 2008, mm-hmm. everyone was on edge.
Yes.
Because no job was safe.
Yes, and the real estate crash was in 2007.
Exactly. And so, therefore, you weren't going to show that there was any, you know, chinks in the armor.
Right.
And I think society is, you know, makes us feel like, yes, I can.
Right.
Okay. But yeah, with a little help from our friends.
With a lot of help from our friends and a lot of help from when it's time to relinquish and get help. And, correct me if I'm wrong, but I did it when I cared for my parents many years ago when they died of cancer. But there are people who do this better than we do, better than I did. We were talking in our last break or the break before about knowing when to hold them, knowing when to fold them.
Exactly.
And knowing that when you try to control this situation, you're not really giving the person that you're caring for the best care.
No, exactly. Because if mom is getting on your last nerve and all she's asking for is perhaps a bowl of soup.
Right.
And you're like, "Mom, I'll catch you when I can." And it's
right.
Like, okay, that was a little overreaction. And at Artist Senior Living, what we tell our families who are exploring us, and it's a very tough decision, we're going to give them a good night's sleep. We want to give them a wonderful night's sleep so that when they come, they can actually be with their family member. We will do the heavy lifting. We're going to take care of the hygiene and making sure that their meals are prepared for them and that they're eating. Some of our residents cannot use utensils anymore. They might use pita bread.
Right.
So we're going to make
a bad thing.
Exactly. They might need to be able to walk around and eat their food because they can't sit.
Right.
At your home, you might be like, "Mom, why can't you just sit?" Or, "Honey, why can't you just sit still?" They can't.
Right. So you can remove the stressors and be a better caregiver.
Absolutely.
If you relinquish, if you internalize and you accept what's going on and you create the right plan, the right umbrella of people, as I call umbrella
absolutely.
Of wellness.
Absolutely.
And that's crucial. So we're going to break now. When we return, Donna's going to talk about creating balance from within. We're going to conclude with a couple of fabulous takeaway messages. So please don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Could one conversation change your life? When was the last time you talked and worked with someone, the right health practitioner, about your health and wellness? When was the last time, or maybe the first time, you received the personal attention and the individual program you deserve? Because no one program works for everyone. And the only program that will work is the one that is truly yours. Coaching for Health is a hands-on, customized health and wellness program that truly will change your life. Suzy Bricker, a certified health coach, will be your personal advocate for living an energized and healthy life. She works with her clients to help them create and maintain a way of life that is healthy, flexible, fun, free of denial, and last but not least, gets results. By working together, bio-individual programs and lifestyle changes are made that are sustainable and that best support and target the individual needs and goals of each client. For more detailed information, please go to Coaching for Health website at www.coachingforhealth.net or email coachingforhealth at susan.brickert@outlook.com. Get the results you are looking for now and for the future, and give yourself the gift of great health and wellness that you richly deserve. Call Suzy at 248-762-4961. Whether your business has 5 employees or 500, they need to work as a winning team. Your bottom line depends on it. Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health will work with you and your staff individually and collectively to build a customized plan that will work for your business. Suzy specializes in health and wellness programs that will improve employee productivity, reduce absenteeism, create a happier, healthier work-life environment, and increase staff loyalty and commitment to their careers and your company, all of which adds up to a greater return on your investment for you, lower healthcare costs, attracting highly qualified new employees, and promoting an atmosphere of financial success. Contact Suzy Bricker at Coaching for Health at 248-762-4961. That's 248-762-4961. And at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. For more information, go to her website, coachingforhealth.net. Find out today how to build and create the right health and wellness program for your business. Call 248-762-4961 or email susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. You've heard the saying, you are what you eat. Think about it. And for most of us, that's not a pretty picture. Compound that with the way our bodies metabolize and break down what we put into them, or not. Well, that's truly a recipe for disaster. Because we primarily consume a diet of processed foods, foods that have no or relatively no enzyme or nutritional content, we create disease all over the body. Heartburn, fatigue, inflammation, of course digestive issues, and a compromised immune system are just some of the issues we deal with daily as a result of this. Enter digestive enzymes. Natural longevity digestive enzymes. PhytoBioForte digestive enzymes and trace minerals. PhytoBioForte is the most potent plant-based digestive enzyme with trace minerals product available. Completely digested foods are the answer or solution to many health problems. And if you begin a daily routine of using PhytoBioForte, you may be amazed at what can happen. For more complete product and ordering information, please go to adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. That's adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. One more time, adaptforhealth.com/WWNN radio. Natural longevity, PhytoBioForte. The choice is yours. Being the best takes time, talent, and determination. Getting the most of those things takes coaching. Think of the most successful athletes or performers. They've all got a stable of experts coaching them in every area of their lives. Don't we all wish we could get, let alone afford, that level of service? Well, you can, without sacrificing quality, by working with Suzy Bricker and Coaching for Health. Suzy has extensive knowledge of healthcare strategies, including nutrition, supplements, and exercise physiology, combined with life and career coaching. The results are life-altering, immediate, and sustainable. To find out how you and your family can benefit from Coaching for Health, go to the website coachingforhealth.net or send Suzy an email at susan.brickercoachingforhealth@outlook.com. Don't forget to schedule your free consultation and be on your way to the healthy, happy life you deserve. Call 248-762-4961.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker. I have Donna Addy with me today. We are having an incredible, wonderful, very heartfelt conversation about caregiving. And during the break, Donna and I, we had a real aha moment. Donna, what was that aha moment?
Well, we realized that often the care recipient is unaware of the stresses that we're experiencing. And they couldn't possibly be. From their perspective, from where they're sitting, they surely could not step into our moccasins and and experience our life. But if we can acknowledge that they are unaware, we can have more compassion for them and more love and slow ourselves down and realize, wait a minute, you know, they didn't bargain for this either.
That's right. And that's crucial, because if we understand that their experience is not ours, and we let go and we really try to create that umbrella and get the kind of help that we need and they need, the right help. It's not about relinquishing. It's not about not doing a good enough job. It's not about the guilt. It's about everybody doing and being who they are.
Well,
right?
At Artist Senior Living, we consider it a partnership. And we are a partner with every single aspect. And I like to envision a apple pie or a cherry pie with the individual, yes, center, but we are all slices of that pie. We're all working together under the same umbrella.
That's right. Okay, so before we go, we've almost come to the end of another show. My gosh, how fast this time goes by. About a minute, talk about creating balance and then give our audience information about you, how to get in touch with you and artists.
I'm going to give you a couple of just easy suggestions at home to one of the things I absolutely love. There's a book, it's called Mindlessness. I'm all about mindless. I'm making a list of mindless jobs. One will either be a toll taker, where I decide, do I want to give a dime or two nickels? Or my second favorite is the person who puts stickers on fruit. So just really, we're so conditioned to always be doing something. When I was a young child, I was often told I daydream too much. I love to daydream. Go off to wherever you'd like to go. Your mind will take you in places unknown, but it's your private. It's your private Idaho. Adult coloring books. I really highly recommend them, because you can pick it up, you can stop, and no one is actually going to be seeing it. And it's very relaxing. And the other thing I can suggest is getting Epsom salts. They cost about $3-4.
I'm a proponent.
Put it in the sink. Most of us don't have a time to take a bath. Put it in the sink. Put some drops of lavender in with it, some essence of lavender.
Right.
Put your hands in it. And just soak your hands. Epsom salts have magnesium, which releases serotonin chemicals.
And releases toxins.
And all will be all right with the world. So that just gives you just some simple things. And my takeaway message is, finding the right balance is the perfect recipe for self-compassion.
There you go. So tell our audience briefly, because our time is almost out, how to get a hold of you. And about artists.
Donna Addy, Artist Senior Living. We have a website, www.artistsl.com. You can learn about us. Our local number is 561-989-9945. You can give us a call. We'll be happy to share information with you. And please just ask for Donna Addy. I'm there for you.
Donna, thank you. It was a pleasure. You will be back in the near future. I just want to read something very quickly, a message for everybody today and moving forward. Attract what you expect, reflect what you desire, become what you respect, mirror what you admire. So thank you all for tuning in to this Coaching for Health with me, Suzy Bricker, www.coachingforhealth.net. 248-762-4961 is my number. Remember, it's all for the health of it. Until next time, take really good care of yourselves. That's the best caregiver. And have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful Valentine's Day.
The opinions expressed on the preceding sponsored program were strictly those of its hosts, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of this station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
If you suffer from excruciating back pain, do not have surgery. Call Dr. Fernando Ranella, MD, and ask him about the new ozone therapy and how it can eliminate your back pain once and for all. End your suffering today.